friend of mine who I haven't actually seen in a while, so I'm pretty excited to hear her talk. Sadie Kirvin is an author, she's a poet, she's an activist, just a general all-around badass. So, Sadie, come on up here.
Thank you, Meg. Let's get this party started. Who's street?
Our street.
Who's street?
Our street.
Every month. when you get off your butts and get your ID or whatever you got to take down there and vote in a system in which thousands of black people and white people together died during the civil rights movement for you to have. Don't spit in the face of that gift. Amen. Utilize it, because I know no other time in history when we've needed it. The racism and the biased politics of corruption and violence against the community is at its best. We have 4 abortion clinics in Texas. How does that make sense? But it will end when you end it. Vote.
I told you that the kids in Ferguson promised me to bring this back to you. These are kids that are sleeping in tents. They have quit their put college on hold, quit their full-time jobs, going part-time, quit their part-time jobs. They are in it to win it. They want an indictment, and we were in Ferguson in the trenches with these children, and they are our leaders of today and tomorrow. I am so proud of those children. So, we're gonna do, there they are. Come on up here, guys. When I heard this, I just thought it was the coolest thing. And they say, please take it back. So, it's the beginning of, what do we want justice, when do we want it now? After we say that verse, we go into indict, convict, send those killer cops to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Okay. What do we want?
Justice.
Where do we want it?
Now.
Indict, convict, send those killer cops to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell.
Indict, convict, send those killer cops to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Indict, convict. Send those killer cops to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Indict, convict, send those killer cops to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Woo!
Fantastic. Okay, Jean. And Jean's gonna come up and speak with Jobs for Justice. That'd be you, yeah. Unless there are other Gene Lances with Jobs for Justice.
My name is Gene Lance. I have been associated with Jobs for Justice for many years. I'm right now the president of the Texas Alliance for Retired Americans. You may hear me on KNON on Saturday mornings, 9 o'clock on the Workers' Beat program. I would also like to say that I'm an executive board member of my union local in the Auto Workers Union, the executive board of the Dallas AFL-CIO, and the executive board of the Texas AFL-CIO. Thank you, buddy. That means I'm associated with labor, and I would encourage you to be involved with organized labor today, because it is amazing how much more progressive they are than they were in the days when I was a college student. We used to call them the AFL-CIA, with good reason. But today, they're very much more progressive. There would be more of them here tonight, and it's my fault that they're not. I went to see the movie Pride, and I bragged about it so much, and I insisted so much that they go, that they set up a night to go see the movie Pride. And unfortunately, this was it. I recommend that movie, by the way. It's about solidarity, it's about winning, and it's about how to lose. Winning is solidarity. Prejudice is losing. In the progressive movement today, I can look back over 46 years of things that I've been involved in like this. At all times, then and now, the causes of the black community were the point of the spear. So you're right to be here. You're doing the right thing when you're here. Don't even question it for a minute. The most profound thing that happened to me back in 1970 had to do with the African American community and a young man I didn't even know. His name was Carl Hampton. I think he was 20 at that time. I was teaching school and going to graduate school at the University of Houston, and I had some vague ideas about education reform, but I hadn't thought it through, and I hadn't begun to think about how serious the systemic problem is in the United States until Carl Hampton did something for me. He pulled a gun on a Dallas policeman. That was on a Wednesday. Now, Carl Hampton's cousin, Fred Hampton, had already been murdered by the Chicago police that previous summer at the Algiers Motel. Some of the older people here will remember that. That was on a Wednesday when Carl Hampton pulled a gun on a Houston policeman. On Sunday night, they surrounded the place where they were meeting. They put a sniper on the roof. And when Carl Hampton came out of his headquarters, they shot him dead. That was the first time that I began to realize that there's something systemically wrong in the United States, and it's focused very, very much on the armed services, and that includes the police. That was the beginning of a long road for me. I'm proud to say that I'm still on that road. I'm not going to get off of that road. I'll be here with you till the day I die, and I thank you for being with me.
You need to leave your partner.
Well, the
is here to tell you today that we are beautiful. We are intelligent. We deserve so much better. We need to dump this oppressive system once and for all. Now, to show our newfound solidarity, I'd like to see everyone's fist up in the air right now. When I say, what do? I'd like for everyone out here to say, fight back, as loud and passionately as you can. Police kill innocent members of our community, so what do?
Fight back!
Police kill innocent members of our community, what do?
Fight back!
Police kill innocent members of our community, what do?
Fight back!
Your bosses cut your pay and your landlord raises your rent, what do?
Fight back!
Your bosses cut your pay and your landlord raises your rent, what do?
Fight back!
Tell him.
Is it on?
There we go.
Okay, listen, I'm into these chants. I got one more from Ferguson. One more from Ferguson, and then I'll do my little speech thing for you. Okay, you guys are going to like this. Doesn't apply to a lot of us out here because we're not young and strong. But it's beautiful.
It is.
Can't hear us? Can you hear me now? Okay. I have one more chant from Ferguson that I promised them to bring. And it doesn't apply to some of us out here because we're not young and strong, but there are a lot of young and strong people out here that are the leaders right now and that are the leaders tomorrow. And the chant is, you just repeat it after me. We're young, we're strong, we're going to keep it going on. We're young, we're strong, we're going to keep it going on. We're young, we're strong, we're going to keep it going on. We're young, we're strong, we're going to keep it going on. We're young, we're strong. We're going to keep going on. You guys remember that. You're young and you're strong.
Oh.
And you don't have to be oppressed. Listen, I lost my only son, Clinton Allen. My son was 25 years old. He was unarmed. And he was shot to death 7 times by a cop named Clark Staller. By a cop who should never have been on the street, had 8 excessive force complaints, 1 attempted murder, and falsifying a police record. But he was on the street because it's a culture in the Dallas Police Department. We are no longer dealing with a few bad apples. We are no longer dealing with a few bushels of bad apples. We are into orchards of bad apples. And so we need to understand what is going on in our community. And we need to be more than Facebook activists. When you see someone on Facebook and you see a cop kicking the shit out of somebody and you just post shaking my head and it's a cop in Austin, Texas or San Antonio, Texas, you know what you can do besides shaking your head? You can Google the chief, the police department, and you can say, hey, listen, I want to know, where is this cop that I just saw on the internet, and if you don't know about this, what's your email address? I'm gonna send it to you. We have to start tagging these bad acting cops. We have to hold them accountable. So what do next? What do? Rallying is good, marching is good for the soul. It makes some people uncomfortable, and it makes some people feel good. But I challenge every single one of you to get involved and fight police brutality, because I tell you, today is my son, tomorrow it's your son, or your uncle, or even your sister. This is not a black thing, or yourself. This is not a black thing, it's not a Hispanic or brown or Latino thing, or an indigenous Indian thing. It's not a white thing, it's not a poor people thing, it's our thing. And we must all be our brother's keepers. We must all be our brother's keepers. I thank you guys so much for coming out. Visit our website, mothersagainstpolicebrutality.com, our Facebook. If you ever see something in Dallas going on, drop us an email at mothersagainstpolicebrutality@gmail.com. We get hundreds, and we answer every single one of them. You are the eyes and the foot soldiers of this movement. You are the eyes and the foot soldiers of this movement. And I'm very proud of everyone that came out tonight. And thank you so very much. Let's keep this going. Let's keep this going. Let's keep this going.